Start up your bird and meet me at the runway. Our departure time is 2200.
Cobaletti, Colt, 1-1, request startup.
Colt, 1-1, Cobaletti, clear for startup, wind 274, at 5 meters per second.
Colt 1-1, Colt 1-2, radio check.
One, copy.
Make sure you update your desired time on target values for the RVIP and RVCP waypoints on the CDU. You don't want to miss the RV.
Pull up. Altitude.
Cobaletti, Colt, 1-1. Request taxi to runway. 1.
Rolling.
Cobaletti, Colt, 1-1, request takeoff.
Colt, 1-1, Cobaletti, you are cleared for takeoff already. Climb 300 at QFE 29.86.
Performance check starts now. Colt 1-1, Colt 1-2, fly heading 245, Angels 8, and maintain an appropriate speed. Hard deck limit is in effect. Do not go below Angels 5 unless the restriction is terminated. Approaching Angels 8, level out and maintain appropriate speed. Good. Maintain 245, Angels 8 and appropriate speed. Use of the autopilot is authorized. Unlike in a daytime AAR, nighttime or bad weather AAR is much more challenging. Judging distance from behind the tanker and rate of closure from behind are the most difficult features to assess. You could easily become disorientated during the AAR, especially in bad weather with limited visibility. For this PO, you have to make 3 successful connections lasting 10 seconds each before we reach waypoint 7. Good luck. Colt 1-1, Colt 1-2. Turn right to 330, maintain Angels 8 at an appropriate speed. Let's review the AAR procedure. Once we reach the RVIP, rendezvous initial point, contact the tanker to initiate the rendezvous. We need to be at the RVCP, rendezvous control point, at the RVCT, rendezvous control time as briefed. We will be using the RV Delta point parallel procedure. I'm sure you have studied the others, Alpha, Bravo, Charlie, Echo, Foxtrot, and Golf. RV Delta is typical for the A-10. If you ever fly combat, air, patrols, you will fly the RV Echo, especially in the MCON conditions. RV Delta requires you to maintain an agreed track and the tanker to maintain a reciprocal track. The tanker will turn onto your track at the computed slant angle based on your speed and the RVCT. Once at the RVIP, you've made contact and set up your TACAN to AATR. Get the range bearing to the tanker. Then safe your switches. Line check and your pre-contact checklist. Fly 1,000 feet below the tanker base altitude until we have a visual. Once you have a visual, contact the tanker for further instructions. Turn your TACAN to AAREC so the tanker can get distance information from the next set of aircraft. If the tanker has chicks in tow, we will remain 1 nautical miles in the astern position. We will only approach once we confirm no AAR is in progress. Once the area is clear, I'll call clear astern. You should slowly move into the pre-contact position. We are at the RVIP. Turn to 270, maintain Angels 8 at 270 knots. You can initiate contact with the tanker and set up the TACAN as briefed. To the AATR so you can get range and bearing to the tanker. Remember to select TCN on the NMSP so you can get the range to the tanker. Tanker base altitude is Angels 15, so climb to Angels 14. We need to maintain 1,000 feet of vertical separation until we have visual. Approaching Angels 14, level off and maintain appropriate speed. Good. Fly 270, Angels 14, and appropriate speed to reach the RVCP at the RVCT. Now let's review the contact procedure. Once clear, you will make a progressive climb to the astern position. Walk the throttles to slowly creep into the station keeping position. Once in position, call pre-contact to initiate contact. The trick is to stabilize behind the tanker, then sneak up to it, slowly. Once in range, the boom operator will then fly the boom into the receptacle. You have to maintain station to keep connected. Make very small movements of the stick and throttle. Once connected, maintain station until refueling is complete. Check the indicator lights to determine your position. Disconnect, depress and hold the nose wheel steering button. Do not pull back on the stick as you could collide with the boom. This will also reset the system for the next refueling attempt. Once refueling is completed, you will maneuver to the reform position on the right side behind the tanker's wing line as briefed. Okay, let's run through the AAR checklist. Master arm switch, safe. Gun pack switch, safe. Laser arm switch, safe. Dismiss weapon status page, deselect. Dismiss missile page, EO power, off. Now perform the line check. Air refueling door, check closed. Engine RPM, at least one engine core, RPM minimum 85%. Air refueling line check button, depress. You may see some fuel vent momentarily. If it persists, then we have a fuel system problem and you should abort the mission. Confirm ready light on within 3 minutes. If it does not come on, then we have a fuel system problem and you should abort the mission. My first night AAR was Sierra Hotel. Clear skies and a bright moon made the job a whole lot easier. Good luck tonight. You're gonna need it. I almost forgot. If the tanker calls breakaway, then immediately reduce your airspeed and drop altitude to avoid a collision. Then set up for the next refueling attempt. Friendly is at 11 o'clock. Fast movers heading north. More friendlies at 11 o'clock. Friendlies at 12 o'clock. Visual on the tanker. Contact the tanker so we know we have a visual.
Ready, recontact.
Colt 1-1, Texaco, chicks in tow, 1 mile trail at 14.
Remember to set your TACAN to AAREC so the tanker can get distance information from the next set of aircraft. Okay, clear astern. Let's run through that pre-contact checklist. Internal fuel quantity, check. TACAN AAREC, CMSP standby. Refueling lights on. Exterior lights as required. Intercom monitor switch as required. Hot mic switch as required. Signal amplifier switch, norm. Fill disable switches as required. Air refuel control open. Confirm ready light.
Warning,
on.
Autopilot.
Good. Move closer to the tanker and call pre-contact.
Ready, pre-contact.
Return pre-contact.
Follow the tanker into the turn. You will be tanking next.
Ready, pre-contact.
Cleared contact.
Get yourself stabilized a little ways back, and then walk the throttles to creep up to the station keeping position. Do not exceed one or two knots of overtake. You lose a lot of booms that way. Focus on flying formation with the tanker and not the boom. Do not chase the boom. See how stable the tanker is? Just relax.
Contact.
You can do it, just concentrate.
You're taking fuel.
Just a little bit more. A little bit of stick and throttle. Just a little bit more, a little bit of stick and throttle. There you go, contact.
You're taking fuel.
Well done. Try another attempt. Remember, stabilize, walk the throttles, fly off the tanker, not the boom. Just a little bit more, a little bit of stick and throttle.
Contact.
There you go, contact.
You're taking fuel.
Well done. Try another attempt. Remember, stabilize, walk the throttles, fly off the tanker, not the boom. Just a little bit more, a little bit of stick and throttle.
contact?
There you go, contact.
You're taking fuel.
Well done. Try another attempt. Remember, stabilize, walk the throttles, fly off the tanker. You can continue to practice your tanking or head for home. It's your choice. Just a little bit more. A little bit of stick and throttle. Just a little bit more. A little bit of stick and throttle.
Contact.
There you go. Contact. You disconnected too soon.
Contact.
Try another attempt. Remember, stabilize, walk the throttles, fly off the tanker, not the boom. Just a little bit more. A little bit of stick and throttle.
Contact.
There you go. Contact.
You're taking fuel.
Well done. Try another attempt. Remember, stabilize, walk the throttles, fly off the tanker, not the boom.
Transfer complete.
Just a little bit
more.
A little bit of stick and throttle. That's enough for today. Let's run through the post-AAR checklist. Aerofuel control closed. Ready light off. Fuel quantity, check. Intercom monitor switch, as required. Hot mic switch, as required. TACAN, as required. Exterior lights, as required. That completes the AAR portion of our flight.
Warning, autopilot.
You did well today. With practice, you will be able to keep station for much longer. Reduce altitude to 8,000 and fly to waypoint 8 for our descent back to Cogoletti. hard deck restriction is terminated. You're permitted to land and shut down your bird. I'll give you a rating then.
Warning, autopilot. Altitude.
Bravo Eddie. Colt, 1-1. Request landing.
Take the taxiway to the right. You can park in the first free revetment on your left. Congratulations. You passed this PO. You received a qualified Q rating. Well done. Return to Cobaletti for the next qualification mission.